The seventh commandment forbids unjustly taking or keeping the goods of one's neighbor and wronging him in any way with respect to his goods. It commands justice and charity in the care of earthly goods and the fruits of man's labor. For the sake of the common good, it requires respect for the universal destination of goods and respect for the right to private property. Christian life strives to order this world's goods to God and to fraternal charity. The commandment forbids theft. Theft is the usurpation of another's goods against the reasonable will of the owner. This commandment, thou shalt not steal, warns against a sin that can easily kill any love between people. Property is a necessary condition of human life. It is security for a man's future and his family and his descendants. And sometimes it is a connection with the past. Frequently, it is a condition for creativity and at times is its fruit. Like a name, property is a symbol of the person himself. Therefore, the man who steals can wound very profound aspect of the tab man's personality, inflicting real moral mutilation.
The Bible says, thou shalt not steal. The student acts except be cheating. Statistics show that cheating among high school students has risen dramatically during the past 50 years. In the past, it was struggling students who were more likely to cheat just to get by. Today, it is also the above-average college-bound students who are cheating. 73% of all test takers, including prospective graduate students and teachers, and that most students do cheat at some point. 86% of high school students agree, cheating no longer carries the stigma that it's used to. Less social disapproval coupled with increased competition for admission into universities and graduate school has made students more willing to do whatever it takes to get the A. Grades, rather than education, have become the major focus of students. Bureau College officials, 35%, believe that cheating is a problem. In this country, than two members of the public, 41%. The seventh commandment enjoins the practice of justice and charity in the administration of earthly good and the fruits of man's labor. The church makes a judgment about economic and social matters when the fundamental rights of the person or the salvation of souls requires. She is concerned with the temporal common good of men because they are ordered to the sovereign good or to make. The duties required in the seventh commandment are truth, faithfulness, and justice in contrast and commerce between man and man. Rendering to everyone his due, restitution of goods and lawful detained from the right to honor thereof, giving and lending freely according to our abilities and these necessities of others, moderation of our judgments. Wills and affections concerning worldly goods, a provident care and just study to keep, use, and dispose of things which are necessary and convenient for the usitation of our nature.
shall not steal. You shall not steal. For our God will supply everything that you need. You shall not steal. What does this mean for us? We are to fear and love our God, so that we do not take our neighbor's money or property, or get them in any dishonest way, but help them to improve and protect their property and means of making a living. You shall not steal.